throne. Your lack of belief in God is not going to make him go away. Your lack of belief in hell or heaven is not going to make that go away either, folks. The fact of the matter is, whether you believe it or not, we're all going to stand before the King of Glory when we die. And I think we all can agree that we are all going to die one day. We're all going to die one day. We don't know the hour of our death, but God does. And I want to make sure that everyone in here is ready to meet God when you stand before him. And the only way to make sure that you're ready to meet God is through Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. So if you love in your lifestyle to drink it up, to smoke it up, to get high, get drunk, and to have sex outside of marriage, you love homosexuality, you love a lifestyle of sin, then you're probably not saved. You're probably not saved. And you need salvation in Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ loved you so much that he came to the earth 2,000 years ago. 2,000 years ago, he came to the earth, fully God and fully man. God had compassion on us, and he came through the children of Israel. He came to be their Messiah. And then he told his apostles to go and spread this message throughout the whole world. And salvation came to the Gentiles, which is everybody outside of Israel. Outside of Israel, folks. Jesus Christ came to save. And if you repent of your sin and believe by his grace in the gospel of Jesus Christ, you're saved. There's a lot of false Christians out here. A lot of false Christians that'll tell you God loves everybody. You can be a sinner and still go to heaven. You can do whatever you want to do in life and Jesus loves you and all those mushy, wonderful things. But let me tell you, this is the same Jesus. This is the same Jesus who formed a whip of cords and cleansed his temple, folks. Jesus Christ is not playing around with sin, but he is merciful. He's merciful to the brokenhearted. He's merciful to the brokenhearted. Those of you that are cast down, those of you that are tired of your life, those of you that see that your life is on the way to hell, it's on the wrong path, it's because of sin has separated you from God. Those are the people that God draws to his son, Jesus Christ, and that lay their lives down before him, repent of their sins, and be saved. But the pride, the Bible says that God hates a proud look. The proud are not heard by God. The proud, those that mock at God, those that mock at his words, those that mock and are proud and hardened in their hearts towards his word, and they're saying, you know, F God, there's no God, I'm going to live the way I want, I'm going to do what I want to do. Those are the ones that God does not hear. Those are the ones that need a soft heart. That need a soft heart. And they'll tell you at the 420 Fest, we just heard it, forget responsibility, keep drinking and keep smoking marijuana. That's a great message for the youth. Destroy your brain. Forget responsibility. Live how you want to live. That's the message of Satan who wants to destroy you. No, hail Satan. You don't want to hail the one that wants to kill you, young man. You have no knowledge. You lack wisdom. You don't want to hail Satan. You want to bless God. You want to come to Jesus who saves. You want to repent of your sin, folks. It's Satan who wants to steal, kill, and destroy. Satan doesn't come as an ugly-looking devil. He comes to tempt your flesh. He even comes claiming to be a Christian sometimes to make you feel good in your sin, to make you feel like it's okay. But we're here to stir up your conscience today. Your conscience towards God and towards Jesus. Folks, 420 is full of wickedness. They're going to encourage you to drink it up and get high, folks. We want you to get high on God. We want you to put down your drink. No, ma'am. We want you to know Jesus. We want you to know Jesus. Because the party's going to be over one day, folks. And that's just the truth. The party is going to be over one day. For those of you who just live for the next party, live to get drunk, live to get high, it's going to be over one day. When you're sober, when you're sitting in your room by yourself, do you contemplate your life? Do you contemplate what's going to happen when you die? Well, we're concerned about that. We're concerned about that. Are you contemplating? Yeah, you're boastful.
Hey, don't be touching myself.
Hey, that's loud. That's annoying.
Hey, that's a song. That's a song. That's a song. Hey, don't do that. Don't do that or we'll call the cops.
Call them.
Don't do that.
Call them.
Don't do that.
Call them.
happens when you preach Jesus. The demons inside of people don't like it. When you preach Jesus, the demons get stirred up. If I was out here preaching about Muhammad, or preaching about Buddhism, or preaching about Hinduism, those demons wouldn't stir up in people. People wouldn't get angry. But when you start preaching about Jesus, Jesus Christ, and when you start telling people to turn away from sin, because that drunken spirit and that weed spirit that's causing you to get high and it's causing you to drown your life, when we talk about that and about how Jesus can save, that's when people get mad. That's when people start assaulting you. That's when the demons start taking over people, because the devil doesn't like Jesus. The devil hates the children of God, and he uses his children to stir up people. He uses his children to act violence against the children of God, because they don't like the message. They hate the message of the gospel. But you know what? Until the day of your death, or until Jesus returns, he's reaching out to you with his mercy. He's reaching out to you with the message of repentance, to tell you to turn away from your sin. That's what God's desire is, that you turn from sin and believe in the gospel. The gospel is the good news. The good news is that you don't have to die in your sin and go to hell. You don't have to die in your sin and go to hell. For those that don't love sin, for those that are desperate, you don't have to die in your sin and go to hell. You can repent of your sin and be born again. You can repent of your sin and be born again. You see, if I gave you a nice, easy message, that people wouldn't hate it. You think we're preaching hate when we're talking to one another? We're not preaching hate, we're preaching love to you. It's the epitome of love to tell you, hey, your lifestyle is leading you to hell. We don't want you to go to hell. God bless you, sir. We don't want you to go to hell. We want you to go to heaven. We want you to be born again. And Jesus Christ created you in your mother's womb so that you might glorify him. We don't want you to waste your purpose for being born. We want you to find your purpose for being born, which is in God. There's something inside of you that God created to dwell in. The Bible says that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. That temple is not supposed to be defiled with drink and smoke and fornication and homosexuality. These are things that God hates. These are things that God wants you to deliver you from. I was saved by grace. I was a sinner. I was caught in fornication. I was a cursing, drunken man. But the Lord Jesus Christ saved me by his grace, and he can save you too. If he can save a wicked sinner like I was and turn me into a saint who loves God and walks according to his will, he can do the same thing for you. He can do the same thing for you, folks. The Bible says in John chapter 1 that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. John is writing about Jesus Christ, who is the Word, the very Word of God, God manifest in the flesh. He